What's good, everyone? So this is going to be a little bit of a switch from your typical Dokkan content. I've been keeping tabs on this game since, you know, the development and the betas and the pre-register periods. It's been out for a few days now, and I've been kind of exploring a little bit. So I do want to break down kind of a general summary. So let's just go ahead and get started. So the tabs I'm hitting on, the first one was the gift. This is the mission. So the one you're looking at right now is the daily missions. Obviously a lot of orbs equivalent to Dragonstone they can get from this. This is like the cumulative missions based on, you know, ranks or whatever. And the last one was events, where currently there's not anything. This tab right here is your ranking. So I guess it puts you up against, you know, other players. Obviously I'm not really playing very heavily, so, you know, falling far behind some of the other more committed people. But yeah, I mean, we'll see how this goes in terms of, like, I was quite disappointed with Legends Revive, so the Hokuto, you know, Musou will be a little bit better. This is pretty much your team options. You've got your, you know, parameters and equipment, and also sorting based on level or power levels. And then the next section here is basically your training portion. Basically, you have all your cards, your character cards, your battle cards, special attack cards, and so on. But you know, obviously I got to represent the main man, Kenshiro, for now. And, you know, I haven't summoned on the reroll stuff. I'll cover that in detail over the next couple of days and just kind of give you general guidelines as to how to go about it. But these are based on special attacks and, you know, skill sets, and also like the support type cards you can equip to the unit. Let's see. The next one is going to be the shop. So first of all, I'm not going to be spending any money on this game. This will completely be kept as free to play. I got enough spending as it is in Dokkan. So all these are basically exchangeable things based on, you know, guild coins or currency and whatnot. This is basically the banner layout. This is, you know, the one you can reroll as many times as you want, depending on what type of character or cards you want. I did test the rates out a little bit. It's a little bit iffy, I ain't gonna lie. It'll take some time if you do want to reroll to a very good degree. SSR fighter rates are like 1%, and you have your character breakdown here. A decent amount of featured units. From a general guideline, I've heard that Rei is a good one. I'm trying to figure out the right way to call this guy. The little bum that Kenshiro is always destroying instantaneously. I've heard pretty good things about that guy too, because, you know, he's able to equip pretty much everybody's skill arts or whatever it's called. Now the bottom two, for one time daily, you get a free summon out of it. So I think the ones with the coins, you can do a free multi every day, once a day. And then also the other one is basically the one single summon type deal. So that's pretty much the format with that one. All right, so these are basically the quests and story modes. This will be the main story right here, and you can actually acquire a decent amount of things there, like training items and whatnot. This will be your quest mode, so you do have like various difficulty levels broken down by normal and hard. You won't be able to unlock the hard difficulty unless you get to rank 11, so keep that in mind. And there are other components that won't be unlocked, like guilds, I think, and the fighting arena until you get to, I think, rank 14. So I still don't have it fully unlocked because I'm still kind of like just diving into a surface level. But we just jumped in. This is kind of the general gameplay. I'm going to be playing this on a auto mode basis. I like to treat this almost like, I don't know if you're necessarily familiar, but Football Manager is a game that I played for a very long time. I haven't done it recently, but the point of that is it's a heavy simulation slash managerial game, right? You're basically just managing things instead of actually going through the process of, you know, in that example, playing the actual matches, right? You're managing the team and units or players in that regard. But I plan on taking a similar approach with this one, where you can still activate your skill sets and special attacks and, you know, ultimate attacks, whatnot, whenever you want to, but it just makes it easier for me. I kind of tend to not really be a big fan of these types of games on a mobile platform. Just the controls are a little bit wonky, you know what I mean? And I'm not necessarily the biggest fan of it. So again, I'm keeping it in auto mode. Again, I guess the point to make with that is you're not going to be able to play at the highest level, I guess, if you're going on auto mode. Obviously, the better players are going to be doing them manually with their own controls or whatnot. But Again, I'm treating this very, very casual for the time being, just to kind of enjoy a nice little distraction from Dokkan when I need it, and that's pretty much the extent of it. I don't plan on, you know, being very, very heavy about this. With the story event, you do have cutscenes and also an actual, like, CGI cutscenes as well. This is a pretty major scene in the manga. It's a pretty important section with the old man and the, you know, the seeds that he was able to finally get for his village. And, you know, there's a sad story, and obviously Ken gets, you know, pissed as shit because of it. But without revealing too much, that's, you know, it does have throwback cutscenes where you can kind of relive the moment in a way. And then if you're a massive fan of Fist of the North Star like I am, you'll tend to enjoy the cutscenes. I mean, I don't watch every single one, but, you know, every now and then it's a nice little throwback. In general, the gameplay works in waves, essentially, right? You have a couple of different waves of enemies, and you'll have a boss battle at the very end. For me, right now, what I find difficult is timing the ultimate attacks and whatnot to where I'll be fighting a boss. Sometimes there's no boss, and pretty much I didn't use any of the special attacks like you just saw there. So there are a couple of things I'm still working out, and I'm still... You know, honestly, it's very new to me too, so I'm still trying to figure out everything. You know, luckily I'm fluent in Japanese, so I'll be able to read and navigate for the most part. But when it comes to a lot of the technical components, it's a little bit, you know, I'm still learning basically. So I do plan on coming out with tutorials and just, you know, basic introductions and mechanic basics and whatnot. Just to make it a little bit easier to understand, and for the non-Japanese speaking players, it might benefit from, you know, having some guidelines and general kind of overview analysis or whatever you want to call it. So I definitely do plan on doing that. I guess the next video I'll post is probably on the reroll banner, basically just giving you the scoop on which units you want to go for and the type of cards you want to try and acquire in addition to your character cards and whatnot. So I definitely do plan on covering that. Probably going to come out over the weekend, but, you know, I haven't really, I've done some research and whatnot, but I'm still kind of exploring the various information out there. So that's the thing ultimately about new games, right, is you don't really have concrete sources of information like Dokkan Battle does with Dokkan Wiki and DBZ space, so it's gonna have to build up over the course of time in terms of, like, you know, the information and databases that are available. So, you know, I'll keep looking. For those that are watching right now that are familiar with it, certainly let me know in the comments if there are very, very useful and effective ways to go about getting information. So we'll go ahead and leave it at that for now. But I mean, in all honesty, this game is it's pretty fun. It's not like ridiculously fun and addicting, but I have caught myself playing this more than I should sometimes. Like, it's actually been taking a little time away from, you know, the Dokkan Battle Link level grind, but, you know, I'm still doing the Link levels too. But for me, I think ultimately I needed kind of an extra break. I was playing King of Fighters All-Star, the Legends of Revive game also in the past, but a lot of things happened since then where, you know, certain things were turning me off, and, you know, I basically, you know, I have the account information, so I could go back in anytime I want, but I uninstalled them from my phone. So let's go through a couple of these. So again, these are the missions. So if you click on the bottom right button, you can collect all of them at one time, so you don't have to do it one by one. If you go over to the cumulative here, based on, you know, certain requirements, you'll get some rewards out of it. And then there is a section for new player missions, which we just clicked on right here. And it'll automatically distribute it to you whenever you fulfill the requirements. So that's pretty much, I think, in a nutshell. So I will cover it in more detail coming up, but hopefully enjoyed it for the time.